This was the moment they'd waited a decade to see. Two icons of the railway reunited. The famous Flying Scotsman back on the main line after a decade of restoration, and the Ribblehead Viaduct on the picturesque Settle to Carlisle line. The Flying Scotsman was built in Doncaster in 1923 and was the first locomotive to reach 100 miles an hour. It's now owned by the National Railway Museum in York and has been painstakingly restored over a decade at a cost of £4.2 million.
If you wanted to refit Big Ben, you'd probably do it. This is the steam equivalent of Big Ben. And you can see around you, the response is great. That's because it's a working machine. And people can see it, they can smell it, they can touch it if they want, as long as it's not going too fast.
Yesterday, the engine carried its first passengers on the main line. From Lancashire, it voyaged north, obscuring the rainy Cumbrian fells with its breath. A treat to watch, and they did in their hundreds as it raced through the hills. Even better to be on board.
I think it's absolutely marvellous that Scotsman back on the airline. You know, it's been far too long that it hasn't been running. It's an iconic piece of British history which deserves to be loved by the public.
It's absolutely amazing. It's just a dream come true, is this?
At Carlisle Station, there was barely standing room. Among them, a former driver.
I think it's a good following. I was 47 years on the footplate, and I did 17 years on the shovel and coal into them, day in and day out, year in and year out. Like, it wasn't just for one day, it was every day. I would do it all again.
From Carlisle, it headed south for a top-up of water in Appleby. These two enthusiasts set off at 5 a.m. and drove from Somerset to be here.
People go watching football, don't they? No interest in that, and this is better. So we had a day out up in the fells, so it can't be too bad, can it?
The journey on the Settle to Carlisle railway was almost halted after a landslip. The train was 45 minutes late, but even Cumbria's weather didn't dampen spirits.
Thousands of people from Carnforth to Carlisle and now here in Appleby have lined the route to watch the Flying Scotsman. And you can see why. It's magnificent.
Yesterday's journey was the latest adventure in the Flying Scotsman's 93-year history. Now back in true working order, it has a busy itinerary this year. So if you missed it, if the rain put you off, or you weren't prepared to travel the length of the country, there'll be plenty more opportunities to see it flying by. Olivia Richwald, BBC News, on board the Flying Scotsman.